الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Every Tuesdays we're going to go through the book تحفة الأطفال. So every Tuesdays we're going to study which book? تحفة الأطفال, youngsters. So I need three things from you. There is three things that I need from each and every one of you. Number one, that you memorize the book. You have to start memorizing. I will tell you the amount, how much you have to memorize. I will tell you. And then you'll go home and you'll memorize it and you'll come back. Okay? That's the first thing I need from every one of you. Are we all in agreement? Do we all agree that you're going to memorize it? Inshallah ta'ala. Number two, I need everybody to have a book and a pen. Not a paper, a book and a pen. So those of you today who do not have a book, but they are writing on a paper, when you go home and you buy your new book for this class, I want you to write everything in there. Okay? Because next lesson, I'm going to check your notes. I'm going to say, give me a book, let me look at it. And I will do that every single lesson. I'm going to check. If you wrote what I wrote on the board. Okay? Number three, I want everybody to have good manners. No one's allowed to laugh. No one is allowed to joke. And everybody has to sit properly. Have to cross your feet and sit well-mannered. So those are the three conditions. Does everyone understand? Today we're not going to start the book. We're not going to start the book today. We're going to do an introduction. I'm going to give you a background information regarding tajweed. What does tajweed mean? What is the history of tajweed? When did it start? What is the virtue of studying tajweed? Where is tajweed taken from? And etc. So we're going to take an introduction today. Okay? The scholars, they say, إِنَّ مَبَادِئَ كُلَّ فَنٍ عَشَرَةٍ. Every subject that you want to study, any subject in the religion, you want to study, there are 10 things you should know about it before you go in. So any subject you're doing, Quran, whether it be qira'at, tajweed, hadith, fiqh, seerah, any subject that you are doing, 10 things is needed. إِنَّ مَبَادِئَ كُلَّ فَنٍ عَشَرَةٍ الْحَدُّ وَالْمَوْضُوعُ ثُمَّ ثَمْرَةٍ وَفَضْلُهُ وَنِسْبَةٌ وَالْوَاضِعُ وَالْإِسْمُ الْإِسْتِمْدَادُ حُكْمُ الشَّارِعُ مَسَائِلٌ وَالْبَعْضُ بِالْبَعْضِ اكْتَفَى وَمَنْ دَرَى الْجَمِيعَ حَازَ الشَّرَفَى. Those are the 10. And we're going to go through each one, inshallah ta'ala. Each and every one of those 10. I wrote on the board the first one, which is Al-Had. What does Al-Had mean? It means definition. What does it mean? Does everyone here know what a definition means? What does definition mean? actual meaning of the word. MashaAllah. What's your name? Mu'adh. Very good. Mu'adh, sah? Good. So, al-haddu. What does tajweed mean? In the Arabic language, it has a meaning. And in the religion, it has a meaning. Okay? In the Arabic language, the word tajweed means at-tahseen wal-itqan. At-tahseen means what? Perfecting something. What is it? Tahseen means perfection. To do something with perfection. Do it good. If you go home and you clean the kitchen, then what you have done is jawatta ay ahsanta. I'm a tahseen. You perfected the kitchen. You did it very well. So in the Arabic language, the word at-tajweed means what? To do something with what? With perfection. And it's to do it well. And itqan means to do it with perfection as well. Tahseen and itqan, they roughly mean the same. Does that make sense? Is everyone understood? So what does tajweed mean in the Arabic language? Perfection. Say in Arabic, at-tahseen. Wal itqan. That's good. Everyone together? Are we all together? Very good. Now we're going to go in the istilah. Istilah means according to the scholars. According to the scholars who teach tajweed, what do they say tajweed is? Now this is not the Arabic language. This is according in accordance to who? The ulama, people of knowledge. They said, fil istilahi, it means huwa ikhraj. It is to bring out. To bring out of your mouth. It is to bring out ikhraj. Kullu harf. Every letter. Where are you bringing it out from? Min makhrajihi. From the place that it should come out from. The dad comes out from somewhere. You bring it out from where it should come from. The qaf, it comes out from somewhere. You bring it out from the right place. So you don't bring the dad and the qaf from the same place. Or the kaf and the qaf from the same place. No. It is to bring out. Huwa ikhraj. It is to bring out every letter. Kullu harf. Min makhrajihi, from its place. Wa i'ta'ihi, and it's to give it its right. Haqqahu means what? To give its rights. Inshallah ta'ala, the difference between the haqq and the mustahaq, we're going to talk about it. This inshallah ta'ala, this is called sifat lazima. We're going to talk about it. These are sifat lazima. Characteristics that are always present. Pay attention. Don't lose focus. And there's the second type, which is sifat arida. We're going to do this, inshallah ta'ala, in Tuhfatul Atfal. We're not going to talk about it now. Okay? And the difference between sifat and makharij will also touch on in where? In the Tuhfatul Atfal, inshallah ta'ala. But this is mainly what we need to know for now. For now, in the madkhal, in this mabadi, in the introduction, we just need to know it is to bring out every letter from the what? From the right place. So tajweed, that's what it means, according to those scholars. Very good. Now we're going to take the second point. How many points did we say we're going to do today? 10 points. So this is the first one. Now we're going to do the second one. The second one is al-mawdu'. Al-mawdu'. Write it down. Everyone write it down. Al-mawdu'. What does al-mawdu' mean? Al-mawdu' means tajweed. What does it deal with? What does it speak about? What is it about? It deals with يَتَعَلَّقُ. It deals with بالكلمات القرآنية. It deals with and it discusses the what يتعلق بكلمات القرآنية. It deals with the Quranic words. So what does Tajweed discuss? What does it talk about? It deals with the Quranic words, the words of the Quran, the letters in the Quran. It deals with that. من حيث إعطائه, by giving it حقها, its rights, ومستحقها. Again, again, حقها ومستحقها. We're going to talk about that inshallah ta'ala in more details when we start the kitab Tuhfatul Atfal inshallah ta'ala. You guys shouldn't take that on right now. Again, what does Tajweed talk about? What do you study in Tajweed? What do you learn in Tajweed? The Quranic words. So you learn the Quranic words. You learn the Quranic words by giving it its rights. What are you doing? By giving it its rights, by pronouncing the qaf properly, the kaf properly, the dad properly, the ayn properly, the ghoin properly, huh? All of those is the thing that ilm al-tajweed deals with, and this is what it discusses. Does that make sense? We're now going to move on to the third point. Has everyone written it? Hey? Yes, you have to write it all.
Okay. In Arabic, Tajweed means perfection.
Perfection in the Arabic language.
And also
Tahsin and Itqan, they roughly mean the same. That's in the Arabic language. The Arabs, they used to use the word Tajweed before Islam came. In Islam now, it means to perfect the Quranic wordings. Not everything. صح? It's only perfection of the Quranic wordings, not everything. Like in the Arabs, they use Tajweed for what? Perfection of what? Everything. If you do something good, that's why the word Jawwada, it means that he did something very nicely. Does that make sense? So again, in the Arabic language, it's very general. Tajweed means perfecting everything. Okay? But in the technical definition, according to the scholars, what is it? To perfect only? The Quran. To give the Quran its rights. The second point was mawdu'. What does Tajweed discuss? What does it deal with? What does Tajweed deal with? يتعلق بالكلمات القرآنية. It deals with the Quranic words. Quranic words. So Tajweed does not deal with what? Hadith. It doesn't talk about how to read hadith, but it deals with how to read the what? The Quran. By giving it its what?
Right.
Its rights. By giving it its rights. We're now going to go into the third, inshallah ta'ala. We're going to move on to the what? The third point. We're going to move on to which one? We're going to move on to the third point, inshallah ta'ala. Put alif and lam there. Better to put it in there. What's the thamara? Thamara means what? The outcomes that we get. Thamara means what? The outcome. So what's the outcome that we get from ilm tajweed? If we study this subject, what is the outcome that comes from it? So number one, the scholars, they say, the first one is الحفاظ على كتاب الله عز وجل. Allah's kitab is protected. What is protected? Allah's book, it gets protected. This is a way to protect the Quran. The Quran doesn't get changed. From the time of the Prophet ﷺ, the Quran was like this, and it's going to carry on being protected like this. Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا ذِكْرَ إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا ذِكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. The hifz of the Quran, the scholars, they say it means hifz al-lafzi and also hifz of what? The hifz of the ma'ani of the Quran. Allah doesn't only protect the meaning, He protects the wording and the meaning. The Quran is protected, it's looked after. So the way that the messenger read it, we till today, we have through the science of tajweed, people who are reading it just like the Prophet did it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how it came down from Allah. Are we all together? So a sheikh listens to a person, he says, correct this, don't say this, say this. And then the person learns it, and then he gives it to somebody else, and then ijaza. So the Quran is protected. That's the first one, that's the first benefit. Number two is an yahfada. Al-insanu, the person, he protects, the individual protects lisanahu, his tongue. The person will protect his tongue from what? Min al-zalal. The person will protect his tongue from what? Zalal means what? Huh? Mistakes. Zalal means what? If you learn the Quran with tajweed, what happens? You will not do no mistake. So by studying tajweed, the outcome is what? Yeah. And yahfad al-insana, the person protects lisanahu, his tongue, from what? Mistakes. Min al-zalal. Zalal means what? By studying tajweed, which one? Zalal. It's with a za. The third one is, the third outcome is al-ajr alladhi yajiduhu. The ajr that the person will find in this world and in the hereafter. By studying tajweed and learning tajweed, what do you get? You get no mistakes, but you also get reward, ajr. How? Because of the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, وَالَّذِي يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنِ, The one who reads the Quran, وَهُوَ مَاهِرٌ بِهِ, he's mahir, meaning he's reading it nicely, no mistakes. He's with who? What does the hadith say? That person is with like the angels, the Safaratul Kiram al-Barara. He's with them. Because he's reading the Quran correctly. Like in the one who's reading, وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ شَاقٍ, it's hard on him. وَهُوَ يَتَتَعْتَعْ. What does he get? He gets two reward, but not like the reward of the one who is reading fluently. So the reward, the ajr, for the one who reads the Quran fluently is what? It's very high. In this world and in the hereafter. How is it in this world? Because he's the one that the people are going to say, lead, lead. Sah? So look at him. He's the one leading. Everyone's listening to his recitation. And in the day of judgment, he gets a reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Very good. Now we're going to speak about the fourth. You're writing still? Okay, right. Is everything I'm saying making sense? Are you sure? Okay, repeat the thamara, first one. What was the first one? Hey? Yes. You said you understood. How are you? What was the first one? The thamara, what was the first one? Al-hifadhu ala kitab. What does it mean? Wait, I want him. Okay, mention any of the three. What are the outcome of the person who learns tajweed? What outcome? What will he get? Just say one thing. No, I want him. Him first. Wait, not him. Yeah? He doesn't understand English? Okay, tell him in Urdu. Don't give him the answer. Hey, تفضل. The second one. Yes. So by studying ilm al-tajweed, you will do no mistakes. Hey, yeah. Any other one? Hey, yeah. So if you read it very well, you'll get a high station, high reward. Hey, yeah? You get a reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Hey, who can remember the third one?
Can I ask a question?
After you answer.
The first one.
Yeah, try the first one.
Allah will protect the Quran.
So the Quran is protected through the tajweed. The Quran is what? It's protected through tajweed. What's your question? So the protection of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in this nation is that Allah protects it through the people. But He'll protect it. There's going to be a people who are going to memorize it and they're going to look after it. So ilm al-tajweed is one of the ways to protect the what? It's one of the ways to protect the Quran. But the Quran is protected by Allah Azza wa Jalla. Regardless, Allah is going to protect it. Like in the previous nations, the previous people, Allah never protected their scriptures. He told them to protect it for themselves. That's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, بِمَا اسْتُحْفِظُوا مِنْ كِتَابِ الْعَدَى. They were told to look after their books. Like in us, no. Allah looks after it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any question? Have you written it now? Yeah? Write it, finish. Finish the right. Yep, finish the last one. Okay, I'm going to write the fourth one over here, okay? The fourth one. The fourth is فضله, the virtue. What is the فضل, the virtue of learning ilm al-tajweed? What's the virtue of learning ilm al-tajweed? If you learn tajweed, what virtue do you get? What ajr do you get? So what's the reward that you get? The scholars, they say, sharaful ilmi bi sharafil ma'loom. The virtue of something is in accordance to what you're learning. Is it the same, the person who's learning medicine and the person who's learning English language? Are they the same? Which one's better? Learning English language, right? No, medicine is better, right? So learning medicine is better than learning what? English language, right? Correct? Why? It has a higher reward, good. What else? Why is learning medicine better than learning English language? It's more knowledge. It seeks more knowledge, okay? It's more beneficial to the people, good. Hey, any other reason why medicine would be better than English language? It will help you more in life, amazing. What else? All of those reasons are correct. Then knowing the word of Allah, is it going to be the same as knowing any other language? Even medicine? Knowing Allah is greater than anything. And knowing about Him is greater than what? Anything. Remember yesterday I said, Allah said in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Allah referred to the Quran as a what? In this ayah, what did He refer to the Quran as? وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا. Life. The Quran is what gives people what? Life. Then, you just said medicine is better than what? English language. Why? Because medicine, what does it deal with? Life and death situation. The Quran is greater in terms of life. Allah says, أَوَّ مَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا. Somebody who's dead, he's not alive. فَحْيَيْنَاهُ. We gave him life. How did Allah give this person who's walking, he's alive, he's walking around, but Allah said, no, he's still dead. Because if you don't have the Quran in your life, you are what? You're dead. Because your heart is dead, your mind is dead, you're not a living person, even though you're alive. Does that make sense? It doesn't make sense. I'll expand on that later. But the virtue of the Quran is you become Ahlullahi. The virtue of the Quran is what? You're going to be from the people of Allah. You're going to be from what? The people of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Okay. So the fourth virtue is you're going to be from what? You're going to be from what? You're going to be from the people of Allah Azza wa Jalla. The people who know tajweed are from the Ahlul Quran. And Ahlul Quran are what? Ahlul Quran are the people of Allah. Al-Imam al-Shatibi, he says in his kitab, the Hirz al-Amani, he says, وَعَلَمْ بِأَنَّ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ خُصَّ بِمَا. Now that's he says in his Aqeelat Atarab al-Qasaid. Lakin in his Shatibiyah, he says, وَبَعْدُ, what do you say? He says, وَخَيْرُ جَلِيسٍ لَا يُمَلُّ حَدِيثُهُ وَتَرْدَادُهُ يَزْدَادُ فِيهِ تَجَمُّلًا وَحَيْثُ الْفَتَى يَرْتَاعُ فِي ظُلُمَاتِهِ. All of this is showing the what? All of this is showing the what? The virtue of the? Does anyone here know Shatibiyah? Have you heard of it before? Have you heard of it? How? He goes through it with you. The Quran is the best thing to spend time with, the best thing to learn, because the person who learns the Quran becomes what? Ahlul Quran, Ahlullahi. You be from the people of Allah. Number five, nisbatuhu. Nisbatuhu means what?
Allah.
Yeah? Nisbatuhu means, where does this science fall? Where is it? What subject does it fall under? Ilmu Tajweed, where does it go? Where is it inside? It's part of Ulumul Quran. It's part of what? Ulumul Quran is a big science, right? Are we all together? Yes. Ulumul Quran is what? It's a big science. It deals with what? Under Ulumul Quran falls Ilmu Tajweed. Sah? Also, what falls under it is Al Qira'at. Also, what falls under it is Ilmu Addil Ay, the counting of the ayat. Also, what falls under Usul Tafsir. All of those are what? Ulumu? All of those are Ulumul Quran. So, Ilmu Tajweed, where is it in? It's under Ulumul Quran. Are we all together? So Ulumul Quran is the big, and under it falls. Are you with me, brothers? The scholars, they divide Ulumul Quran into three. ما يتعلق بلفظه ما يتعلق بمعناه ما يتعلق بشكله. لفظه means the pronunciation. This is Tajweed and علم القراءات. ما يتعلق بمعناه هنا, it is what? Two things, tafsir and al-waqf wal-ibtida. Al-waqf wal-ibtida. Because you have to know where to stop. You have to know the meaning to know where to stop, and you have to know the meaning to know where to carry on from. And the third one is ma yata'allaqu bi-shakli, that which is connected to. And here is what? Ilm al-rasmi, where the person learns the rasm of the Quran, and also ilm adil ay, how to count the verses. Those are the three. Are we all together? So this is, you don't have to know this now. You don't have to know it. Ulum Tajweed, where does it fall? It falls under Ulumul Quran. So question, if somebody asks you, hey, Ilmu Tajweed, you're studying it, where does this subject go? Where is it? What do you say? It's under Ulumul Quran. Does that make sense? We'll stop there, inshallah ta'ala. We take five today. And next Tuesday we take the next five, and then we start the Tuhfatul Atfal the week after. Okay? Anyone have any questions? Sometimes I go fast, okay? Sorry, I forget myself. Any questions? Yeah? Okay, the next class is Tuesday. Next week Tuesday, so you have 7 days. Next week Tuesday, I want everybody to have a book called Tajweed. Write on it, Ilmu Tajweed. Buy a new book for me. And then when you write, teacher, Ustaz Abdul Rahman Hassan, yes. This is my book. Copy all of that on there. Huh? Yes, write all this as well. This one is not too important. Don't write. This is not important. Don't write it. Hey, yeah? Huh? You have to? You have to read at your home. Yes. Try to read at home, yeah. Fadal. So, what we took today, so you want me to summarize the whole class today?
No, only the main point. Like
everything was main. Everything was important. So, that you want me to mention the five that we mentioned today. The first one is Al-Had, which means definition. We took Had. Sah? What was the second one we took? Mawdu' means what? The topics that are inside Ulumul Quran, sah? What it deals with. What does it talk about? What does it discuss? That was the second. Third one, what did we say? Al-Thamara. What did we say Al-Thamara is? The outcome. Thamara is the what? It's the outcome. Ayah number four. Fadluhu, it's virtue. If you learn ilmu tajweed, what happens? What are you going to be from? You're going to be from Ahlullah, the people of Allah. Number five, what did we say? Nisbatuhu. Nisbatuhu means what? In how? What subject does it fall under? I'm aware, does ilmu tajweed go? Where does it go? Under ulumul Quran. Huh? Nisbatuhu. It means in accordance to other sciences. Any other questions? Fadal. The next class we're going to be. The next class we're going to do the remaining five. So there's 10 things that you have to know before you study anything in the religion. We already said 5, and then we're going to do the next. We're going to do the next 5, and then we're going to start the Tuhfatul Atfal. Okay? But on Sundays, we're not doing Tuhfatul Atfal. On Sundays, we're doing topics. So we talk about different topics. Every Sunday, there's going to be different topics, random topics. So every Sunday, it's a random topic. Lakin, on Tuesdays is what? No, Tuesdays not. Any other question? Does anyone have any other question? Are you sure?
Yes.
The Tuhfatul Atfal. We'll try to print it for next week, inshallah. Well, not next week, the week after. No, you don't have to bring it for Sunday. Yeah? You have the book, that's good. Okay? Should we conclude and stop here? Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.